Greetings and more greetings from New Zealand. I'm Eric Bakker, the naturopath. So, we're talking about salicylates, okay? Salicylates are basically chemicals found in plants that ward off insect attack, but they can also make you sick, but they're found in massive amounts in various medications. That's a nutshell. Now, why did I get salicylate sensitivity is the question. Did it just drop in your lap like a plague of locusts? Did it just drop on your head like a big shower of goodness knows what? No, it didn't. It developed in you, okay? The sensitivity developed in you for a few reasons. Some people are certainly more prone to salicylate problems than others. If we look at asthmatics or people with autoimmune disease or compromised immune health, can be more prone to any kind of sensitivity. But the thing, interesting thing with salicylate sensitivity is usually creeps up on you slowly, a bit like a bad marriage. You know, it just goes, it starts off good, but then it goes a bit shady and it goes murky and then it turns dark and it gets all gross up here and then the whole thing falls over. That's what happens with a lot of medications on people. They stay on drugs, the drugs infiltrate the body, they suppress the symptom, but then they start toxifying slowly the liver, the kidneys and other organs. They're getting a bit of toxic residue buildup, so they develop side effects. This is what happens with aspirin. Okay. As I mentioned in a previous video in this series, in all the years I practiced, many, many years, every single year I would see one, two, three, or four patients, often males, but could be female too, usually 70s, 80s, on aspirin every day for years. Take an aspirin. And then the patient would come in, and the very first thing they would talk about is how itchy their skin was or how blocked their sinuses were. Okay, nasal polyps, I've seen a few occasions, nasal polyps in these patients. And and I looked at the case, and I had a very good look at the doctor's visit the patient had. I looked at the medication, and I put one and one together, and it ain't three, it's two. And I quickly worked out that the drug was the problem. I had one guy in his 80s who was furious when he came to see me. He said because it was causing him literally suicidal grief because he was just ripping the skin off his back. And this guy's on two aspirin tablets a day. So when I mentioned aspirin, he just threw them in the trash can. That was the end of the itchy skin. But it was also the end of the relationship with the doctor and the end of the specialist. This guy was hopping mad. And when I had a look at his back, it was outrageous. I can't show you photos online of patients or their bodies, but I've taken pictures, for my own records. And when I look back at those photos, this guy looked like he'd been whiplashed, like his whole back, like, you know, literally on one of those Norwegian kind of movies. What do they call them? Those Viking movies where they got someone spread out on a rack and they're just whipping the hell out of his back and the skin's all, that's what his back looked like. It was awful, and it was aspirin-induced. That's the sad part, okay? So, and this hasn't happened once or twice. This has happened quite regularly. So why did you get it? Well, you took too much salicylic acid, okay? It stimulated your body. Or you had a higher susceptibility, okay, to a lower dose than many people have. So it was one of those two. But for where I'm sitting on this chair, nearly all cases I've seen were medication-induced. Like they weren't brought on by eating mushrooms or eating a tomato or having a couple of mints in the mouth here and there. They contain negligible amounts of salicylic acid. But when you've set up that problem already, negligible amounts are enough to stimulate the immune function. Okay? But the big kahuna is the aspirin tablet you're taking every day. Okay, that's the most likely to cause the problem. Or Pepto-Bismol or a muscle relaxant or an anti-inflammatory. But just check carefully that it isn't aspirin if you're getting all this itchiness, okay? If I can just help one more person with this information, that will be awesome. Because I can only manage to help three or four every year who came to me, and they're usually older guys that were so sick of being bounced around from doctor to doctor to doctor with no answers. So don't you be bounced around, all right? So why you got it? Well, you were susceptible to getting it for various reasons, as we've discussed. Thanks for tuning in.